Hello, I'm Charlotte from Lovefood, and today we're going to be looking at great British puddings, starting off with rice pudding. First things first, ingredients, we've got short grain rice, butter, vanilla, lemon, sugar, and cream, and a lot of milk as well. You can flavour it with whatever you like. I've gone for lemon and vanilla, some people like nutmeg. So let's get going. First we're going to measure 50 grams of butter. There we go, and we just need to wait for that to melt, and then we're going to add the sugar to make toffee sauce. So this now looks nice and gooey and golden, so that's done. We need to add the rice now, and what we're basically doing is toasting the rice in the buttery sugar mix. We're using 100 grams of rice. What we want the rice to do is go pale, puffy and golden around the edges. So keep the heat on when you're doing this, because we are cooking it. And every grain of rice should be coated with that sugar butteriness. So we're ready for the next stage, which is adding a lot of milk, and it must be whole milk. Whilst that's over there, bubbling away happily, we're going to split the vanilla pod. It's very easy, just lay it down flat like this and cut it through the middle. Okay, so I'm just scraping the vanilla seeds out of the pod with my knife, and then straight into our ricey mix. It's actually a good idea to put these used vanilla pods into the mixture as well, just so you get all the flavour from it, and then we'll pick them out later before we bake it. I'm also going to add lemon zest to my rice pudding because I think it gives it a nice light airy finish. I'm just going to use half a lemon though, because we don't want it to be overpowering. So now the only thing we need to add is double cream to give it some viscosity. It's not that much, just 150 millilitres. We need to bring this to a slight simmer before we transfer it to the oven. I'm just going to pick out the vanilla pods before we do that. Crank up the heat and we'll wait for that to start simmering. This is the dish that I'm going to use, and as I said, it will feed about 4 greedy people or 6 normal people. Okay, so we're going to leave that be for 2 hours, and after that time it should be lovely and gooey and glorious and perfect with jam. Wow, that looks like a proper English pudding. Time for the taste test. Oh, that is just fantastic. It's creamy, it's comforting, it's rich, very English. I couldn't ask for a better pudding.